Hi children, how are you all? I hope you all are keeping well by the grace of God. Students, in this video we are going to learn about the uses of magnets and also what are the methods to prevent demagnetization. Students, first of all we are going to learn about the uses of magnets. There are a vast variety of uses a magnet or the magnets can have. The first one is the magnets are used in magnetic latches and catches. These are small devices that are connected to doors, windows and cupboards that ensures these structures to shut firmly. The magnets present in the magnetic latches and catches that help them firmly shut these doors, windows and cupboards. So this is the working of the representation of the working of the magnetic catches and latches that are attached to doors and windows. Now students, the magnets are used in handbags and purses. The region where the purses are shut, in that region the decorative button inside that a small magnet is hidden. When these both pieces come in contact with each other, these magnets present inside them will attract each other and they will shut firmly. Now students, the rug pickers, they have a long stick in their hands. While they collect the materials that is meant for recycling, useful materials from the garbage heaps and also from the rubbish, they use a long stick attached with a magnet, and this magnets will attract the materials made up of iron, nickel and cobalt. If we more precisely say, they are collecting mostly the objects made of iron, the pieces of iron from the garbage heaps. So these scraps of iron will be attracted towards the magnet and they can collect in their sacks. Now children, the cranes are used where the industrial waste or the factory waste are, or the manufacturing units of various articles where their waste is dumped from that region. The crane operators, using a powerful magnet, they collect objects made up of iron from the huge garbage heaps around the industrial areas or near to factories or near to manufacturing units that make metallic items. Now children, we know that the loudspeakers, radio, tape recorders, Bluetooth devices, they use magnets inside them. Children, there is usually a ring shaped magnet used in the loudspeakers. They magnify the amplitude of the sound signals that enter into the device and it intensifies the sound signals. So these magnets are used in the loudspeakers, radio, such devices. Now students, the credit cards, debit cards, ATM cards, the airline tickets, all these are having a magnetic strip on them. In such cards also the magnetic strips or the magnets are used. We have seen the refrigerator or the fridge. Students, in the door of the fridge there is a magnet to ensure that the fridge door is properly shut. Then Children, we know that the stickers, the magnetic stickers that are used for decorating a room or a wall, and they are having small magnets attached to them. The magnetic latches and catches behind the doors and windows or in the cupboards, you can see in this picture they are used their safety, a house's safety, and also to ensure that if the person that uses them forgot to shut the door, they will automatically shut. Here handbags and purses that we already discussed, they also have small magnets inside them to keep them tight or tightly closed. Then students, from the garbage heaps using the cranes and other devices also, there is the scraps of iron is collected, and this scraps of iron that is sent to the recycling units and new articles are made with this. Then the motors, pump sets, generators, they use magnets. These are also using the power of magnets to work them. Here, usually in these devices, these electronic equipments, we know that there are round shaped magnets used. The ring shaped magnets, we know that magnets are found in different shapes, like a rod shaped magnet, horseshoe magnet, disc shaped magnets, ring magnets, etc. In such devices, usually the ring shaped magnets are used. Here you can see a loudspeaker in which the picture of a ring magnet is shown in the slide. Now students, what are the methods to keep the magnets safely to prevent demagnetization? What is demagnetization? The process of losing the magnetism in a magnet, that is called demagnetization. If the magnets are kept simply somewhere, it will tend to lose its magnetic powers. So they should be handled properly. The magnet can also lose its magnetism when we drop a magnet from a height. That means if the magnets are continuously dropped from a height, then there is chance of, or the magnet will lose its magnetism. And second thing is that if we heat a magnet, the magnet will lose its magnetic powers. So first method, that means for losing the magnetism, that is dropping from a height, and the second one is if we heat a magnet, the magnet will lose its magnetic powers. And the third one is that if we hammer, means beat a magnet with a hard object, if we hammer a magnet continuously, then also the magnet will lose its magnetic powers. So students, it is very important that we must keep the magnets properly to keep their magnetic properties for longer periods of time. The horseshoe magnets and the bar magnets can be stored with the magnetic keepers. Here you can see the bar magnets best be kept in pairs with their opposite poles parallel to each other. Opposite poles parallel to each other. At the end of their poles, there should be, between the poles, there should be a piece of soft iron. And in between the magnets, there should be a non-magnetic material like a wooden piece or a cork or a piece of rubber should be kept. So children, how we can keep a bar magnet properly? Bar magnets are safe to be kept in pairs. They are opposite poles parallel to each other, and between these poles there will be two pieces of soft iron attached to them, and in between the two bar magnets there is a piece of wood or a piece of cork or thermocol or rubber should be placed, and it should be kept in a small box and is closed. Then these two magnets will retain their magnetic properties. Then children, the horseshoe magnet, that is a U-shaped magnet, we know that their opposite poles almost coming in the same direction. So a single piece of soft iron can be used between their north and south poles to keep them, means to prevent them from losing their magnetic attractive properties. So students, the magnets can be stored properly in the labs and in the places where the experiments are done, and also in manufacturing units of various articles in which magnets are used, where the people store the magnets properly so that these magnets do not lose their magnetic properties. That in case of bar magnets, they are kept in pairs, and in case of the horseshoe magnets, they are kept with a piece of soft iron between their poles. So students, we learned about the uses of magnets and also how to prevent the demagnetization in this video. I hope you understood the topics. Thank you.